to see so much people, so many people here, even after dinner and lunch break. So we have a really tight schedule, even more than yesterday afternoon. We have 6 talks in 60 minutes, which means 10 minutes each. And so we start with the first one, and don't leave afterwards, because afterwards there's even a big surprise if you look at the program. So we start with the first one from Giulio Casale from the Imperial College of London about RADON.
Okay, so thank you very much, and thanks for attending my presentation. RADON is a new European project that started at the beginning of this year. I'm coordinating a consortium consisting of 8 organizations through Europe, mostly companies and cities. And in this submission to SummerSOC, we wanted to overview the challenges that we see ahead in the research area we are working, because we like to inspire us and others to work on these topics and interact with us. In particular, the area we are interested about is serverless computing, which is essentially the ongoing trend to make cloud services easier to deploy, run, and manage. So the idea is that it's to have a zero administration approach to running cloud services, whereby you deploy and consume services on the cloud, and then the complexities of management, for example, I can think that the ones coming from autoscale performance management, just to mention one, are handled by the platform with a greater degree of automation than in the past. This has captured the attention of many practitioners, while also finding in serverless computing the possibility to prototype quickly applications that they can demonstrate to their customers. So in some cases, even in a matter of hours, you can come up with a composition of functions and backend services using the service offering that allows you to demonstrate running applications to a customer. And one of the benefits of this model of serverless computing is that it has enabled the diffusion of serverless functions as a service, which is a particular instantiation of this principle that we want a zero administration approach to cloud platforms, in which we have essentially that we can run the functions on the cloud as if they were say web services, but with the important difference is that they can autoscale and they can manage the underpinning infrastructure automatically without essentially a significant interaction with the user in terms of the network part. And moreover, this means also that a building model can be more fine-grained. If you call a function in the cloud, you might be charged just for 100 milliseconds rather than for the whole hour of the year. And so this model has been seen as particularly interesting for a number of application domains. I think, for example, to IoT, where you have event-driven workloads. It's very natural to see that events, or either produced by the environment or from the data, trigger the call of these service functions, which we just said are cheaper to execute and don't require complex management stack. And so these events lead to essentially the loading memory from the platform of a function if it's not already there. So this happens through containers, so it's a containerized environment, and then the function executes and gives back the results, typically an external storage, because these are stateless functions. So these functions are also short-lived, and so they might have also bounds on the resources they can use, for example, memory, etc. And as you might know, for those already familiar, serverless bus is quite often associated with AWS Lambda. AWS perhaps unsurprisingly, has the biggest market share in this segment. But it's so dominant in the market that the concerns have been looking. So with our project and our research agenda, we would like to essentially propose a holistic framework based on DevOps principles, so both for development and for operators, in order to facilitate the development of complex service-based applications which can possibly run on different service offerings, in the sense that if you decide to refactor your application and you have developed on AWS, and then tomorrow, after a appropriate adjustment to the code, run it in combination with functions from say, Microsoft function offering, we want to support this kind of engineering efforts to a holistic framework for software vendors. And so we are conceptualizing in this period of time a number of tools that can be done, can be created to this aim, like integrated development environment, a modeling environment, because we would like essentially to use models to abstract the details of the deployment and ease refactoring from an architectural point of view, but also to automate the orchestration. And so we have our entire environment that helps the delivery and also the abstraction of the different target service platforms. So for example, we are thinking to have an event ontology that allows to relate events generated in different clouds or different application environments in a holistic manner across the whole application built with our system. And of course, we have also tools for quality assurance. So I will not have the time now to explain what we want to do, so I invite you to come to my post. For that, I will just spend a few slides to highlight some of the challenges that arise in this research agenda. Well, an obvious but important and significant challenge is the one of modeling serverless path-based applications. So if you use modeling languages like Tosca or Tools, for example, like Miner, which are very helpful to describe complex intelligent applications, and you do not have yet support for service functions. And it's not trivial to validate because you need to add events, you need to reason of the behavior of application. So you're exposing at the level of the topology and orchestration model more details on how the application works than we had before when we were just primarily looking at the infrastructural resources. So there is a interesting blending between the application logic and the infrastructure plan. And this, of course, require further research. So another challenge, for example, the composition trade-offs. So we hear quite often about nano services, microservices, monolith web services, and so forth. But then it is not easy if you want to create an application that relies just on one of these stacks. But in reality, you might have legacy components, you might have complex hybrid architecture, so you need essentially to reason on how it is best to deliver your new high-value service, which of these features you're going to use, because you can support them all in your organization. So there are decisions of how to come up with the right architecture, decomposing the application logic into different components. And this requires that also we introduce constrained definition languages for models that we might have shown on the previous slide, because as we search, for instance, for optimal architecture, we use a search-based software engineering approach, we need to constrain the architectures that we can accept based on the individual characteristics of, say, like a microservice versus service functions, so forth. Think to the resource needs that are in place for the functions. We need to reason about these as you decide the optimal architecture. Last slide. it's of course a runtime operation in delivery, so where everything gets more sophisticated because you have these hybrid solutions where you have the serverless functions, and you can imagine applications that, for example, have part of the logic on a public cloud, part of the logic on a public cloud using these serverless functions. And now this causes clear issues. For instance, if you think to events, you go on AWS and you have events to describe the level of the cloud or what happens. Someone deposits an image on a storage, but when you look at your private environment, you don't have events. Maybe you don't have certainly the same events if you have a new environment. We need to come up with an abstraction layer to reconcile this technology. So I think this offers a lot of outlets for research. Thank you very much.
Thank you. So our next speaker